The bridegroom's mother hardly spoke to anyone during the wedding, saddened by her son Paul's choice. She did not like Rose at once, because she was an arrogant and narcissistic girl who loved luxury. The wise woman really liked her son's previous girlfriend, whose name was Jenny. She was very modest and simple. But men are usually not interested in homely modest girls. They want a girl to look bright, behave provocatively and like to have fun. And Paul happened to meet such a party girl. Rose instantly turned the young man's head, which made him quickly forget about Jenny, who he was going to marry. Paul was a handsome and hard-working young man. While still in his 20s, he started his own small furniture company. At first he worked alone, fulfilling orders literally in his garage. He did his work with quality and at a fair price, so gradually he gained a name and many clients. Then Paul hired employees and expanded his business. Soon after their wedding, Rose and Paul sold his apartment and bought an expensive house in an upper-class neighborhood. Rose always wanted to live in a way that made all her friends jealous. And Paul was a simple guy and did not like to stand out financially. But now the man found the pluses in it. He believed that thanks to his wife's love for the luxurious life, he was not standing still, constantly moving towards high achievements. The only thing that upset Paul was the attitude of his mother and Rose. The women did not get along, though they did not clash openly. However, it was possible to invite his mother to visit him only if Rose went somewhere for a long time. Hope for reconciliation appeared only when Rose and Paul had a son. Contrary to the fears of Paul's mother, Rose was not against her mother-in-law babysitting her grandson, giving the young mother the opportunity to go to the salon, to the gym or to the shops. And the grandmother lovingly cared for her little grandson. But there was one thing that made her more and more wary. The fact that Rose and Paul had gray eyes, and the baby had dark brown ones. In addition, the woman saw no resemblance to her son as a baby. She tried to hint to her son, but Paul said that if she didn't want to ruin her relationship with him, she should never say horrible things about Rose again. Paul's mother kept her promise and never returned to such talk. Paul also avoided touchy subjects, trying his best to take care of his family. He wanted his loved ones to be the happiest on earth, and he had to work hard for that. One day during a medical examination, a man was diagnosed with a disease and the doctor advised him to ask about his wife's health. In other words, the doctor hinted that perhaps Paul's wife was cheating on him. At home, the man tried to talk to his wife, but was rebuffed by Rose in such a way that he was ashamed of himself. Rose quickly accused him of adultery, shouting various invectives at him, and then said she would immediately pack her things, take the baby and go to her parents. The frightened Paul began begging Rose for forgiveness. Only after he brought out of the room a box with a ring, which he wanted to give as a gift on the anniversary, the woman calmed down a little. And then she said, as if nothing had happened, that maybe Paul had contracted the disease at the swimming pool. Paul was cured long and hard, feeling humiliated. He decided never to go to the pool again and to be more careful in the future. From then on, they lived as before. Their son grew up. Rose enjoyed life, getting prettier and bolder every day. And Paul worked hard, trying to satisfy all the desires of his beloved wife. Her main passion was traveling. She loved to fill her Instagram with pictures from expensive hotels. She was taking pictures on vacation so often that Paul began to call himself her personal photographer. Before their upcoming trip, Paul had company problems and couldn't fly with his wife. Rose did not want to hear about any problems and threw a tantrum. She shouted that she had spent a lot of time to find the best hotel and choose the most beautiful swimsuit, that she had already told all her friends and was not going to humiliate herself in front of them. Then Paul suggested to take his friend instead of him. Rose calmed down and pretended not to like the idea, but it was better than no vacation at all. So Rose went away on a trip. Paul's mother spent days at her son's house taking care of her beloved grandson. The boy was 5 years old and demanded a lot of attention. Grandma took him for long walks at playgrounds and parks, cooked his favorite meals and read books with him. One day she came home from the playground confused. The woman knew that Rose had gone on vacation with Carol. But it was Carol she had seen running through the park today. The woman didn't know whether to tell her son, because she remembered their conversation many years ago. But after weighing the pros and cons, she told him. The son looked at his mother reproachfully and that was the end of the conversation. Paul did not sleep half the night, and in the morning decided to call Rose via video conference. His wife appeared on the screen, wrapped in a white towel. They talked for only a few minutes, when suddenly something happened that Rose never expected. The door leading to the shower behind her swung open, and a naked man stepped out. He quickly realized that Rose was on a video call with someone and hurried out of the frame, but it was too late. Paul noticed him. Rose understood too, and rushed to disconnect. Trying to rectify the situation, she sent Paul a message saying that there was something wrong with their connection. In response, she received a message from him with saying hello to Carol and that he was filing for divorce. Contrary to Paul's expectations, his wife did not rush home on the first plane. When she returned home, she did not make excuses to Paul. On the contrary, she accused him of being to blame for everything, that he should have spent less time at work, and more time remembering that he had a wife at home who also needed attention. Paul didn't accuse her of anything. He only insisted on a divorce, offering the unfaithful wife a nice payoff. Rose didn't argue and left the house, taking everything she wanted. The woman did not want to further burden herself with taking care of her son, so he stayed with Paul. Time went by, Paul got into his work so that he could think less about his ex-wife. Life seemed to be getting better, but fate once again gave Paul a surprise. His son was hospitalized with pneumonia. The next day, Paul came to visit him and his mother, who stayed with the boy in the room. The joyful woman immediately told Paul that his ex-girlfriend Jenny was the doctor on this unit and that she had become even more beautiful and kinder than she had been. When the man entered the doctor's lounge, at first he didn't know what to say to Jenny, but the woman quickly diffused the situation. She said that everything would be fine with his son and their relationship in the past, and then she talked only about the boy. The next day, Paul invited Jenny to go for a walk with him after work. At first the woman refused, but Paul insisted and she agreed. They took a long walk in the park, drank coffee in a cozy coffee shop, and then he drove her home. Paul was stunned. She seemed to be his Jenny, but she was no longer the girl he had heard all those years ago. She was quite a serious and self-sufficient woman, and Paul liked that about her. The next day, when Paul arrived to visit the child as usual, his mother immediately began excitedly telling her son that she had overheard nurses on duty discussing that their boy had a blood problem. They flatly refused to explain anything to her, so Paul should go and find out everything from Jenny. Jenny listened attentively to a frightened Paul, and then she said that she had no intention to say anything, but as it turned out, she had a suspicion of a lack of family ties between him and the boy. It is impossible for a child of parents with blood type O to have blood type AB. She said something else, but Paul could no longer hear. He left the office, determined to put the doubts to rest. The man took a DNA test, which confirmed his worst fears. The boy he was raising was not his biological son. Paul arrived at Jenny's house later in the evening and begged her to talk to him. On getting into his car, Jenny saw the adult man sobbing profusely. Jenny stroked him on the back and told him to get over it and not to get too upset, because the father is really the one who raised the child. She said that in time Paul would surely marry and have more children of his own. After these words, the woman fell silent and turned away to the window. After a long pause, she looked at Paul and he saw tears in her eyes. And then she whispered that in fact he already had his own child. Paul stared at her perplexedly, and the woman told him that she had found out the day after their separation that she was pregnant. She decided not to tell Paul anything, as she did not want him to marry her out of a sense of duty. She looked through the gallery on her phone and showed a picture of her daughter Mary. This conversation changed everything. It took time for Paul to understand and organize everything in his head. But when it happened, he decided to beg forgiveness by all means. Jenny was wary of the man from the past at first. But he was so sincere, so caring, that she eventually melted. And Mary was especially happy when she learned that she had a father and a grandmother and even a brother. I hope you enjoyed the story. Have a great day and see you again.